What's up, everybody? DCinemas here, bringing you another reaction video, and again, we are featuring with my guest here, Game Master 468.
Oh gosh, why?
Yes, as you can see, my victim here is crying. I have him tied to his floor.
Oh. Why are there fire ants in my pants?
Yep. I'm not going to show you any visual footage of him right now. It might traumatize your brains. But what we will be saying will do the same anyway, so I don't know what the purpose of that is. We are here watching episode...
What draws are these zombies using?
Okay, well, that's happening. Cabin in the woods. No. we're watching episode 1 and possibly 2, technically. It's one whole 22-minute episode. I don't know why they call it episode 1 and 2. Just call it one episode. First episode, what the fuck ever, of Uncle Grandpa. Yeah, we mentioned Uncle Grandpa at the end of my reaction video of what was that show called? Almost Naked Animals. God damn it was almost out of my brain for a second there, and I had to think about it. Shows how lucky I am. We're gonna be watching episode 1 of Uncle Grandpa and giving our reactions to that. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. So anyway, we're gonna count down to 3, and as like pretty much when I get to 3. That's when we're going to click play, so, because we're both watching this at the same time this time. He's not just listening to my reaction. We're both legitimately watching this episode together. So, unfortunately. One, two, three.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm on an acid trip. Walking.
Good morning. Oh.
Okay, I legitimately don't even know what the thing. What the fuck is this?
What?
First off, this is my first time watching this show. Legitimately, I've only ever seen a few clips of it, and never finished an episode in my life. Are we still on the intro? What is that music? Where the fuck is it? Oh, his nose got eaten. Okay. What? Aqua Teen Hunger Force is the only thing that can do this kind of imagery right. What the fuck is this?
Okay, that was kind of funny, but... Why is he in the cannon? Why is he... Where... What even...
Oh my god, we're in the mind of Pee-wee Herman. We have to be.
Hey!
Is this the Blue's Clues universe where everything talks?
No, this is Pee-wee Herman's world where everything talks. And where anything can happen.
I can physically feel my brain cells dying.
I'm sorry, my brain is... My brain's already dead.
Who are you?
I'm your Uncle Grandpa.
Oh my god, kid, I'm so sorry. So he's everyone's Uncle Grandpa. Makes me wonder, Does that mean everyone's related? Like, everyone's related. Or is he just everyone's
this
grandpa?
Seeing the first few minutes of this episode totally makes me that much more excited for the Steven Universe and Uncle Grandpa crossover.
Oh my god, I forgot that was happening. What the fuck?
Why? What is even happening in this?
Why does it seem inappropriate?
Knock, knock. Who's there?
Uncle Grandpa.
Uncle Grandpa.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Too mature. Too old-fashioned. Too confusing. Maybe later.
Too confusing. Dude, he has Hermione Granger's spell for, like, the infinite bag. What the fuck?
This guy needs to be donated to science. This is a scientific breakthrough right now.
Legitly, but he doesn't have the brain of one. Now that is something they need to look into.
Try it on.
Okay.
He needs to be experimented on.
No, this guy has too much power. This guy has too much power for himself. What the fuck?
I gotta save him. The Belly Brotherhood is a brotherhood that can't be broken.
Plus his mom's gonna be like super mad.
Good point.
So this is how we get our plots? This shit happening?
Regular show does this kind of method so much better.
Yeah, because, I mean, you kind of expect it with that, and this is, I don't know, what the fuck?
It at least starts somewhere sane first, and then gets to the weirdness.
Here's the issue I have with the show, though. It would be better if this wasn't a humanized type of world. I mean, it's like they kind of put this guy in a real world, where none of this shit should be happening. What the fuck?
Is that a Twilight joke?
I guess it is a Twilight joke.
You gotta save me! But I don't know how! Use your belly like I did!
But your Uncle Grandpa! I'm just a kid!
No! You're a belly brother! I believe in you.
Oh my god, this is worse than fucking Friendship is Magic. This is like... You know how they say, no, we have the most powerful magic in the world, friendship. This is just like, this is literally the script doing whatever the fuck it wants to.
Okay, you remember in the last react I was in, I was saying that Equestria Girls was comedy gold compared to Almost Naked Animals?
Yes.
Almost Naked Animals is comedy gold compared to this.
Now, to be fair, you did laugh at a joke or two. I haven't, but you did.
True.
Gotta give some credit where it's due, at least. At least on your part. For me, I still
Even
haven't found anything
funny. Even on
the
Almost Naked Animals, when I watched back the your react thing, I did get a laugh out of one joke in there, too. So.
Yeah, the only thing that made me laugh was the one that, where the guy... I forgot what the line was again, but it was something the octopus said. Guys, like, that was kind of funny, the way he delivered that line, but...
Deeper.
Hey guys, I'm fat too. Can I do that? I want you to share my video. I'm sorry for that image. Then again, you're seeing this, so what am I apologizing for?
So the moral of this episode, okay, it's that it's okay to be fat because your fat belly has superpowers.
Yeah, we're fucking powerful. Better than everybody! Yo, we're so fat, give me the Doritos, goddammit!
So, listen, Uncle Grandpa, kids, go and chow down on those cheap cheeseburgers.
Uncle Grandpa, the role model that we all want.
You don't even have a shirt on!
Go shoot yourself.
Uncle Grandpa taught me that belly brothers don't have to wear shirts. Uncle Grandpa? Yeah, he's right here.
You're being institutionalized. Slicing life with Pizza Steve, bruh. Well, this is all very interesting, you know? This right here.
Oh, yeah.
I was watching a humorous comedy show.
Oh, really? It was humorous. It must have been this one.
A humorous comedy show.
Yeah, he had just as much fucking enthusiasm for it as we do with this show. Oh yeah, remember when Total Drama Island was a thing?
Yes, I did.
Yeah. Back before they decided to make a new series every 5 seconds out of it.
Yeah, like it wasn't that bad of a show, but they started milking the hell out of it. Me, although I did kind of like 16 better than it a little bit. Don't know why, though. I mean, because the other night I actually watched the first episode of 16. It wasn't that great, so I don't see why, but... Look, we're talking about other shows than this one.
Yeah, that shows how bad this show is. When we'd rather talk about other shows than what we're watching.
Yup. Oh, so he's a wizard.
Yeah, wizard Harry. Yorgapa.
Hey, you're not Yorgapa. I'm Yorgapa.
Is that a reference that we should be knowing, or like, is that another show? I don't get it.
Wizard battle.
Yeah.
Reading is magical.
That's right, Caleb.
Reading is magical? What?
Bruh.
And now he just leaves that kid behind to possibly die.
Fuck him, he's in this show. He deserves to die. Uncle Grandpa, okay, where shit happens just jokes. Because it can.
Fourth wall jokes like that can be okay every once in a while, but when that's like the whole show, it's...
No, you know what? Like, I've been playing Conker's Bad Fur Day, as you know, and that is perfect when it comes to breaking fourth wall. It's like the equivalent to Deadpool from fucking Marvel. They're perfect. Maybe he's out. Maybe she's out with some boys. Again, Uncle Grandpa, where shit happens just cause it can. 3 days to get loose. 3 days. Oh my god. A UFO.
A UFO.
Nope. We just need to become detectives.
Yeah, because that's easy. I mean, just look at Sherlock Holmes. He didn't have to do jack shit to become a detective.
We need to follow that magical rainbow trail she leaves behind wherever she goes.
Okay, I can't help but feel a little freaked out every time that fucking happens. You just have a fucking arm coming out of a pouch. Excuse me? Magical.
Reading rainbow.
I'm gonna actually say that right after saying magical, like the reading rainbow. She just finished up her mystic brown. Are you a really bad, like muscular woman?
Is this a girl?
Or are you a man? The only way
we're gonna find you. You have
cross-dressing.
You have the boobies, but you have the voice of a surfer dude, and...
I don't know. Hey, it's all cool to be trans, but I'm just confused. That just happens. Just like the show, anything happens, anything happens. Okay, this is racist. Gotta have Asians working at the salon, because that's what they do. The stereotype.
Okay, this got creepy.
She's gone forever, and it's all my fault.
Okay. I think she's dead.
That's jumping into conclusions a bit. Oh, we went to a cemetery. I guess she's dead.
Gee, we tried looking for her for like 3 minutes, and now we come to the conclusion that she's dead.
Yeah.
Uncle Grandpa, in a nutshell. Remember, I'm not laughing because the show is funny. I'm laughing because I'm making my own jokes out of it.
Oh, golly. What have you done? What have you done, Uncle Grandpa?
I'm pretty sure Dexter's Laboratory did this at one point. And if it wasn't Dexter's Laboratory... Fairly Odd Parents, I believe, did it too?
Yeah, Fairly Odd Parents did it, yeah.
Thank you.
Remember us the episode with like the hamster and you kind of kill it one? Yeah.
Yep. So this scenario has been done before.
Yet another better show than this.
It used to be. Well, actually, it might still be a better show for all I know, but all I know is the first couple of seasons were definitely better. Bitch, you're a pizza. One bite out of you, you're fucked. I just realized it has eyes. I just realized that thing has eyes. You realize that?
What does?
The pouch. Technically, the shirt with the white dots on it are his eyes. Look at that. It has lips and everything.
Oh my.
It's a face. That's what I thought. What the fuck?
Okay,
I have to admit, it's pretty fucking funny. The whole, like, the animation. What the fuck was that? The tiger just shot out a rainbow. What?
As I was saying, let me remind everyone, there's a kid fighting a wizard in space right now. While this is going on.
So I just left the door open? So that rainbow, she farts out a rainbow every time she walks or goes somewhere. And yeah, there is a kid in space right now. Uh-oh. I have no fucking eye. Oh my god, are you kidding me?
Yeah, because this joke was so funny the first time, right?
Yeah, and we just had to reuse it. Of course they bring him back for the end.
Like I said, this kid is probably dead now.
Yep. And he's air humping the air. Okay. So it's not over yet. Another poor kid to be forgotten by this guy. And put in danger.
I don't want to hang out with this kid.
You don't mean kid, you mean Uncle Grandpa.
yeah, sorry, Uncle Grandpa. Why would anyone hang out with this guy?
No fucking clue. For
some reason, the character design on that kid reminds me of the character designs in Gravity Falls.
Please don't mention that show. This show does not deserve its name to be mentioned.
Yes. Ah, okay.
Because that is a much better show, ladies and gentlemen. Letter opener.
Letter opener?
Okay, then.
And what do you use for actual swords?
And why wouldn't you use that instead? Because he needed to make a joke, that's why.
Nope. Nice catch! Now what were you saying, kid?
You fucking kidding me? All that for a freaking fish. One fish. And it wasn't even fished legitly. This show just denies ending. It does not want to end right now. It's still going. For the love of God. Yeah, because that's not freaky or anything.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
Was that the real Uncle Grandpa?
I don't know.
Was that just a suit the entire time?
We had a reference to old Garp, whatever the fuck that was. I don't know if that's a show, or if that was just made there to try to be funny. None of that was funny. The only thing I kind of laughed at wasn't even really the show itself. Well, I guess kind of got to give credit to it is the animations of the tiger fighting. Like, it's so bad and ridiculous. And the tail going around and snaggling the snake is what really did it for me, because the tail, the way it was animated, just looked so fucking hilarious. And it just choked the hell out of the snake and took him. That made me laugh. But besides that, the show is nothing. There's nothing. There is nothing. What are your thoughts?
I don't know. I'm still trying to process what I just witnessed.
I mean, I'll give it this. It's not worse than Almost Naked Animals. I'll give it that. It's not worse. You can probably find some enjoyment in it if it's your kind of thing.
I just disagree. I think this is worse.
You think so?
I think so. Like, okay, like I said, there's a few jokes that I thought were kind of funny. I don't even remember what they were. Something, I think, I don't know. I'll remember when I watch the video back, but...
Yeah, it's kind of hard to say, because... Like, in Almost Like an Animal, it made me laugh once. This made me laugh once. But I feel like this would have been more enjoyable than Almost Naked Animals. Just for the fact that it's like... I honestly don't know.
I'll say this. The animation is more tolerable than Almost Naked Animals.
Yeah, I'll give it that. Not all the characters make you want to...
It's more, like, energetic, even though the fourth wall breaking gets kind of, like, unnecessary after a while. I'll give it that's like pretty energetic with animation when it comes to that.
Yeah, and also it's much prettier on the eyes, and I use that line I just said very loosely, because it's not one of the prettiest shows ever. Almost Naked Animals had characters that are completely ugly, just like they're abominations.
Every single character in that was just hideous.
Yeah, especially that fucking sloth, like, burn it with fire.
Yeah. I don't even know. It's like, Mitch comes on screen, just like, hey man, I really dig that. Can you do it again for me, baby?
I got what you need. I got what you need right here.
You wanna buy a watch?
Wanna buy some Rolexes? Maybe some Coke. Maybe a child's magazine, I don't know. If you're into that kind of thing. No, oh my god. Almost Naked Animals completely sucks. I think this is just a little bit better, not like it's a big improvement. I just think it's slightly better in the animation. Possibly the jokes, if you're into that. I didn't think any of the jokes were funny. I mean, none of the jokes really were funny to me. The only thing that made me laugh was the animation of the tiger, which I don't know if that was because, I mean, obviously they did the weird animation on purpose, but I don't know if that the actual fight scene was supposed to make you laugh. I have no idea. I just ended up laughing because the animation was so ridiculous.
I think for this show, you need to be in a certain mindset to enjoy it. Like, I think this is one of those shows where you're supposed to just kind of just turn your brain off for a bit and just kind of revel in the stupidity, I guess.
Here's my stand. As you know, I'm a pothead. At least I was in California. I don't think even if I was high, I would enjoy this episode any more than I did now. You know what I mean? I don't think that there would be much improvement on this. Even if you turn your brain off, and being high usually does that for you, makes everything funner, no matter what it is. I mean, I watched Sharknado.
Well, I was just thinking, like, just being that kind of mindset. It's like, it's stupid, but whatever. I got 22 minutes to kill, you know?
Yeah, well, in that case, I mean, we just did that, technically speaking.
Yeah, that's really all the show is. It's really more of a time killer than anything else.
And even if that's the case, it's still running. The show is still running for a time killer.
I don't know. Like, I really don't think it should have gone this long. I especially don't think... Okay, while we're on the subject, let's talk about that Steven Universe and Uncle Grandpa crossover. Okay? Why, I don't... Have you seen of any of Steven Universe?
I've seen up to 11 episodes. I haven't seen any of the new, other episodes after that. It's been a few months, but yeah, I've seen a few episodes.
Okay, from what I've seen, Steven Universe seems to be kind of a story-driven kind of show. Like, it does kind of what, I don't know, but, like, it's
kind of like what Adventure Time does, except not as random. It's like, every once in a while you have continuity where, like, something happens.
It's nowhere near as random. This...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's nowhere near as random as that. This show actually sticks to the character development more often.
Or better yet, it's more like Gravity Falls in a way... It's more like Gravity Falls in a way where it's like every once in a while you'll have that episode where it progresses the mystery, but every other episode is like just its own thing. Whereas Adventure Time, it's
exactly.
Literally just random crap. So I don't want to compare it to Adventure Time because Adventure Time is completely random crap. Gravity Falls, at least every episode has its own kind of story plot going for each one and its own moral. So
exactly.
Steven Universe can have that too.
Yeah, Steven Universe does the same thing. Not every episode really moves the story along, but even if that's the case, the episode at least, like, develops the characters in some sort of way.
Yeah.
So, there's always, even if it's not moving the story along, it's at least moving something along. Uncle Grandpa would not mesh very well with that kind of show.
Especially with Steven Universe's animation. They so
exactly.
Much more...
They're two completely different animation styles.
Now, they can argue the fact, like, well, Jimmy Neutron did that with Timmy, with Fairly OddParents.
Yeah, but they at least combined the two animations. Like, go into the 3D world, well, all the characters are 3D animated.
They
made
it
in the 3D world, all the characters 2D animated.
Yeah, they made it work that way by mixing the two, by making them each go into their own universes. In this, how's that gonna work? I mean, maybe they can do that if it was like, but the thing is, they're both animated. It wouldn't look right unless they turn Uncle Grandpa into the same kind of animated style that Steven Universe uses, and then have Steven from that show look like the way their animation looks. I don't see it working in that way. It's like a mashup of those two. I mean, I know I said it would make more, like, the animation style, like, I'm not saying it would make more sense for it to have a crossover with regular show. That would also be quite a leap. But I think animation style, it's much closer than that. And plus, it's more believable in a way, because in regular show, you know random shit happens. That's just that's that universe. And Uncle Grandpa, you have a realistic world where this shit does not happen for any ordinary person. And only Uncle Grandpa is apparently the wizard, or whatever the fuck. It's not really explained, it's kind of skimmed over that he's a wizard and has powers and shit.
And, yeah, it wasn't Harry. I think I did that joke already, but...
Where the fuck does this guy come up with his powers? It's kind of weird. I'll be with you in just a second.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to start getting this over. I gotta start helping my brother go to bed and shit. But yeah, it's just, I don't see the crossover really working. Unless they have like the best writers in the world, I don't see it happening.
Even if even if there's the slim chance that it could work, they can't make it part of like a major like story arc type of thing. It needs to be like its own separate thing or whatever.
Kind of like how the Jimmy Neutron crossovers were. They're pretty much their own thing. They don't really progress.
Well, those shows didn't really have any major story arcs either, so...
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. From time to time, they would do that, but not very often.
Yeah, like, Jimmy Neutron never had its, like, a plot that progressed. It was always, each episode was its own thing. But every once in a while, they had continuity, like the superhero powers and stuff. See, the battery died again. Wow. Both of them last 13 fucking minutes. Anyways, since the fucking camera decided to die and you're seeing a fucking picture or whatever the fuck, or maybe just the end, question mark, or whatever the fuck I feel like fucking putting up, I apologize for that. And I guess this will be the end of the reaction. Now, both my batteries seem to be fucked at 13 minutes for some fucking reason. Got any last words, game?
Good morning.
Good morning. I'm here to... It's a good thing it's morning, too, because I'm going to be in your fucking nightmares tonight.
I'm going to go watch Equestria Girls, too.
Oh, my God. That review is going to be coming up a lot sooner than I would have liked, I suppose. Well, thanks so much for coming, guys. I hope you enjoyed this reaction for as bullshit as this ending was for this video. I apologize for that. Anyway, hope to see you guys next time for the next react, and most importantly, my next review of Treasure Planet coming this Sunday, when it's done.
For real this time.
For real this time. Maybe.
Maybe.
Peace out, everybody.